You're in a certain stage of your company where you need to connect with your customers. What better way to do it with a community? This system that I'm going to show you is best for mid-market and enterprise companies that sells consumer products, services, as well as software as a service, SaaS. So this is going to help you connect with those customers and help them showcase the products, talk with them, let them know about the announcements, question and answers, change logs, roadmaps in case of SaaS. And there's a lot of things and features that we're going to be able to do with this community. It's called a Bettermode. And what I'm going to do in this video is show you how good this actually is and how easy it is to actually set up. So let's go jump over to my desktop right now. The community platform that I'm talking about is called Bettermode, and it's going to help us nurture those customers that we've worked so hard to acquire, because we're going to have a close relationship with them in this community. Now, I'm going to show you some quick things that you're going to get with Bettermode. We're going to jump into a demo account, and I'm also going to show you how easy it is to set up. So first of all, you're going to get access to discussions, ideation, questions and answers, help center, events, resources, and a bunch of things more. Like I said, for example, if you're going to use this on a SaaS, you get access to change log, roadmaps, et cetera, and all of this inside of Bettermode. Now, if you want to check it out, link will be provided in the description. Now, let me show you this beautiful community that we've created as a demo. It's an imaginary furniture store. And let me show you how really good this layout looks for a community. Now, you can have something like this or even better, or customize it. So for example, in this home section, we have our search bar on the top so we can search around this community. We have the new challenges, which are kind of like posts that you can create and just give feedback, show some new things that you've created and create these. Hot conversation section, need any help section, and you can disable these and enable and customize it to your liking. There's the feed section, just like you would on a community social media platform. You have your posts here. They can like, they can follow, they can share, they can comment on this. And it's just super really nice to have this community to engage with your fans, your customers, or potential clients with these type of sections, okay? There's the furniture, just different sections that are created in this community. The new arrival section that we can create, these are spaces that we can create. Now in these rooms, there's spaces that we can create independently for each one of these. Now we have this potential system that you can create spaces for different types of situations so people know they can engage in different type of sections of these spaces that you create and they don't get mixed around, kind of like categories, okay? And then there's sections like support, ask an expert. Like again, you can disable, enable these sections. There's challenges, there's rewards. And if we want to create a brand new post, we click on this plus button and we can add a new post. Now in this section, we can create a new post. We have the categories here. And again, we can customize these, we can disable them and add them. Now, if I had a change log, we'll have the option to create a change log from here. Now, in this case, if I want to create a new arrival post, I do so by clicking on it. And then I have the options to add title, content, the second hand item image, the state, the price, the buying and selling, tax, SEO options. Obviously, people want to rank on search engines, so this gives us options for this. And then we have the advanced options. So a lot of options here, okay? Let's go back into the home page. There's also the ad space. So one of the cool things about Bettermode is that they have pre-built templates to make things really easy. Now, you can go ahead and just start from a blank page if that's what you want, but they already have templates for the most frequent use cases. For example, if you want to create a discussion section, questions, guidelines, landing page, ideas, articles, events, product updates, change logs for in case SaaS, podcast, feed, and job listing. So if I click any of these, I'm going to select an interesting one, change log. So I'll create a change log right here. I'll create for new updates and improvement. I'll leave it like that. I won't change it. I want to make this public, so I'll remove it from private. And I'm going to set it in the section for get help. So I'm going to set it here right now and I'm going to create it and it's going to be automatically added to the community. Okay. So here we go. We have our change log here in the help section. Now be aware that I'm in a demo account over here. So it's a user. In this case, it's a Michael Jackson user. I'm in incognito mode and I'm going to refresh here. Go ahead and refresh it. And we have the change log. So as the user, I'm able to view a change log here and I'm able to view here really easily, okay? Now, if I need to add something on the change log, I do so from here. I'll go back. If I need to edit settings of my change log, I have the options here to settings. If I do wanna make it private, if I wanna change the name, if I wanna change it from a different section. So if I don't want it to help, I can change it somewhere else. I can add members, view members. So if you have this private, it's a really good use case to add members individually, you can do so here. Moderation, analytics for this specific one, audit logs, customize, and leave. So it's a super easy way to do it. We can also add collections. I can go ahead and name it and then start it. So we have collections on the left and we're able to view those and invite members individually just by sharing the link or by the email address. So you can select the role, the space to join, and the custom message. So it's a really useful community to create here. Now, where does the customization come in hand? Okay, when I click on my avatar, me as the admin, I have the option for the account settings and the administration. In the administration is where we're gonna be able to set up this beautiful community that we're gonna create on Bettermode. Now in this section, we have the option to view our members in this community. So we're able to view the image that they have, the name, the username, the email, the staff reason in case it's from the staff, created ad, updated ad, last seen. And then we have a lot of options available to take control of our community. So we can view the profile, we can edit it, we can share members, we can manually change the badge or add badges if we need to, member analytics, audit logs, reset password, flag the member in case it's, something's going on, suspend the member if they're doing something wrong, remove member and report member. So all these options that we have available to take control of our community. Then we have the staff. And in staff, again, we can view all the staff members. We can add a staff member if we need to. So we can select the name. For example, if we want to convert him into a staff member, we select him. Select the community role, the admin, moderator, or member. So if we want to send moderator and the space admin to the section here, and we go ahead and select it and add them. So it's super easy. We have the invitations. We're able to view here the invitations, profile fields, and badges that we need to create to identify users. For example, here's a badge for a new member. And in this case, the user I created, my profile, here's Michael Jackson, and he is a new member. So there's a badge to it, okay? So that's the one I've created, and you create more badges here. Next is we have the content. In the content, we're able to manage the posts, the spaces, and the tags, all of these. We can also create if we want for each one of these. Then we have the customizer. This is where we're gonna customize our community. So for example, in this section, I'll go to spaces and let's get started with the home, okay? So in home, we have the sections that we have available here, okay? Now, each one of these sections has a trash button if we want to remove it or a gear icon to change the settings. So this is what I really like about Bettermode because it's highly customizable. So in this case, for example, the search bar says, what's on your mind? Maybe that doesn't go with the flow of my company and I want to change that. Well, I can do so here and I can change the text. I can change the space where I want to add. I can add an image to it, primary post. I can add buttons and do more with it. If I'm done with it, click away. I can do this section. I can go next section here. And again, I can edit this. And depending the section that I edit, it's going to give me the different type of views. So this is a card view and there's a row view also. If you want to change it, see how it changed, and we're able to preview that. I'll leave it in card view because that's how it looks better for this particular section, okay? Display style, content preview. And again, just like I changed this, I can go ahead and go back. Here we go, and I can change different type of sections. So for example, the change log that I created, okay? So here we go. We have the settings for this particular sections, and for the change log, I'll go to gear icon. Now on these settings, I have the option to add the title, description, display link and heading. So if I enable this, you can see there's a link on the top. I don't want to enable this. The tab views, in this case, we're viewing the latest. And in the latest, we have the options for everything that's going on inside of here. Now, let me show you. For the source, we're viewing the current space, specific post types. So it's a specific one. We're viewing the change log. If you want to add another filter here, you can do so by adding it. For example, the tag, if I want to add a filter for each one of these, but we don't want to add that in the change log, the title, the author. Let me go back. There's the sort. If you want to use the sorting here, for example, by default, it's the release date, but maybe you want to use it by version, by type, by reaction count, etc. On the changelog, you don't want to use reaction count, but you get the option. There's filters. So the inline filter, I can enable this and it enables a filter for us. You can see that this was added on the top and the filter can be used inline or model. You can also view the fields by tags, title, author, published date, type, version, release date, etc. And you can enable all these filters for it, okay? I'll leave it on for now. There's the layout setting. So right now we're viewing card. It could be list, It's a little bit more compact. I like the card view because it gives users in the changelog, but it's going to depend how you want to use it. Number of posts per page. So maybe you don't want to keep it really long. Keep it 10 or less. Display show more. The fields. So each one of these fields, when I hover over them, it's going to highlight what it's going to add or remove. So for example, if I don't want to display the version, I can go ahead and remove it. But in this case, I do. If I want to show tags, I can do so. Publish date, which might be a good idea for the change log. And all these options available. So let's go back into post. There we go. And in post, we're going to be able to do a lot more. But I really like how customizable this is. And you can go in through each one of these sections. I don't want to save this. I go in through each one of these sections and start customizing it so it looks unique. So it's pretty cool that we have these options on the customizer. Next, we have the settings. So basic settings, where we're going to add our community logo or our company logo, community name, terms of service, privacy, policy links, default spaces, the permissions, the media settings, and white label. Authentication. We have all these options to use as authentications. Our custom domain, so we're not using a subdomain, private messaging, moderation, localization, notifications, SEO settings for SEO purposes, search engine optimization, you have it available here, security and privacy, and the billing settings. Next, we have our reports. Reports are really detailed and nice. Reports, you have a quick overview of everything, so check this out. We have the reach and engagement, the people, the post, spaces, audit logs, and email logs. All of that is available here. And then they have a really unique feature, which is apps. A lot of available apps here. So for example, there's cookie consent management, Google Analytics, Zapier. For example, I have Zapier installed. There's MailChimp, Discord, and HubSpot, Salesflare, Zendesk, and a lot of them that we can use. Now, if you need from the apps that are not available yet, you can go ahead and vote for them. So for example, I'll vote for GitHub. Okay, I want this, and I'll give them the reason why, and I want GitHub. So I'll pick a reason. It's a must-have for me. So again, that gives them an idea of what needs to be implemented next. Now, in this case, I have Zapier enabled, okay? So that's connected to Zapier, and let me show you how powerful it actually is. So here's Zapier, and I am connected with Bettermode, and there's two sections to this integration from the app. So there's a trigger and there's the actions. For the trigger, I have all these options available. So collection lead, member added space, member updated, new collection, a new post. And these could be triggers. So for example, when I create a new post, do something with it. Post it somewhere else or on a different platform or generate an email saying that there's a new post, etc. We get these options. And there's also the action options. So in actions, we have these options available. So you can create a post, a created space. So this could be, for example, if you create a blog post, well, you can set it to automatically post with this action using Zapier. So a lot of available actions with this. So see, really neat option to have these apps, okay? So basically with Zapier, you can do practically anything, but there's a lot of options available here. But like I said, if you need a working platform for a community to nurture your customers, your fans, and all of that, this is a great option. So like I said, if you want to check out Bettermode, I recommend that you jump into the link that I'll provide in the description and start testing it out for yourself and see how good it actually is, like you've seen on this video. And that's a wrap.